Let's talk for just a moment here about some of the requirements that functions have. So one of the things that I meant, that I said when I first described functions, is that it's not so important that you know like how the code that's in that creates the function works, but it is important to know what you are supposed to be putting into the function and what you're likely to get out. So here's a function that's built into Python called max, and that function takes numbers. It can take one to many numbers, and what it'll do is go through the numbers. Each argument is a number separated by columns. It'll go through each of the arguments and pick out the largest one, and that's what the function will output. So it's going to go through, it'll determine that 5 is the biggest number, it'll pass that out as its return value, and then that will go, that return value in turn will be put as the argument of this print function, and I will see what the largest number is. So it can just be 3 numbers or it can be more numbers. Let's go ahead and run this cell. Now we see an example of an error here. And so if I look at this error, it says max expected 1 argument got 0. So this basically tells me that if I'm using the max function, it doesn't work right if I don't pass in an argument. It has to have at least 1 argument. So it's different from the print function. We saw it was totally fine to not pass anything into the print function. All right, let's take a look at this. So here's another function that's useful. This is called len, and len is a function that you pass a string into it, and it tells you how many characters long that string is. We may find out later that len has other uses, but for now, we'll just think of it in the context of strings. So if I pass in the string dog, it will tell me that it's 3 characters long. So we'll try that out. Now here's an interesting thing. What happens if I pass in parentheses that don't have anything in between them? Quotation marks that don't have anything between them. Quotes with nothing in between them is called the empty string. So let's see what happens. And then let's also see what happens if we pass a number in. So I'll go ahead and run the code. So we can see the length of the string dog is 3. The length of the string aardvark is 8 characters long. The length of the empty string is 0. It's totally fine. It is a string, but it is a string that has a length of 0 characters long. And this actually turns out to be a pretty useful thing. We may see in some future examples some ways to use the empty string. However, if I try to pass a number into the length function, then Python throws a fit. It says here that the object of type integer has no length. So it basically is telling me that I'm not allowed to do that. Now we can try some other things. Let's see what happens if we do this. Let's try passing nothing in. The other thing, I'm going to show you a way that we can use comments. This is called commenting out a line. So here I have a line that is troublesome to me, and I don't really want it to be in my code anymore, but I also don't want to get rid of it. So I can just simply put the comment symbol in front of it, and now Python will ignore that, although the text is still in my code in case I want to uncomment it later to try again. So let's try running this. Okay, so it says len takes exactly 1 argument. Okay, so len is also not cool with having no arguments. All right, let's comment that line out. Let's uncomment this line out, and let's try putting this 42 inside single quotes and see what happens. Now if we run it, it says the length is 2, and the reason is because what I have here is not the number 42. It is the string, which is composed of the characters 4 and 2, which is a different thing from the number 42.